safe. No vaccine is always protective, and no vaccine is always indicated. Please remember that. That's so important, okay? Why would we vaccinate immunized animals every year? We don't vaccinate ourselves every year, okay? So why don't we understand that immune memory is basically lifelong? We have to accept that. Immunological memory provides durations of immunity for core infectious diseases. Those are the ones that are important, clinically important, that far exceed the traditional recommendations for annual vaccines. This is supported by a growing body of veterinary information as well as well-developed epidemiological vigilance in human medicine that indicates immunity induced by vaccination is extremely long-lasting and in most cases lifelong. Since 2003, these statements still apply today. So as Dr. Schultz says, my friend, be wise and immunize, but immunize wisely. That sounds so trite, but it's true. Be wise, immunize, but do it carefully. The last puppy vaccine should be at 16 to 18 weeks for protection. And so you need to give one later because most of the puppies have been immunized, right? The mothers have been immunized, so they have high protective immunity levels longer, up to 16 weeks today. So you need to give one from 16 to 18 to make sure, if you're going to give just one, make sure you give it later, okay? That's the idea. The last kitten vaccine can be a little bit earlier. I'm not going to try to use this thing. It's too complicated. Okay, so what does the World Small Animal Veterinary Association say about puppies and kittens? About 10% of puppies and kittens fail to respond to a primary core vaccine when the last one is given at 12 weeks. Many inserts tell you you give two doses, 9 weeks and 12 weeks, and the animals are fine for life. That's absolute nonsense. They're not. Many of them will not be protected if you stop at 12 weeks. You must give it later. You can give 9 and 12, but then you have to give another one. Okay? They have persistent walking maternally derived antibody. So the new recommendations, and this is from the World Small Animal Association, give the first one at 8 to 9 weeks. Give the second one 3 to 4 weeks later. The third one at 16 weeks of age or older. Now, you could also measure vaccine antibody titers instead. That's the alternative, okay? And there's nothing wrong with doing that. We do it a lot. Okay, after that, core vaccines were generally given at 12 months of age, or 12 months after completion of the primary vaccine series. To me, that's more important. It's not when they approach 1 year of age. It's 12 months after the end of their puppy series. So the new recommendation is to give this vaccine at 6 months of age, becoming the last in a primary series of four. Now you don't have to do that at 6 months. You can bring Mrs. Steinberg in and talk to her about doing a blood test instead, right? That blood test doesn't have to be drawing an intravenous sample. You can cut a toenail too short and put it on the test strip, right? But it will tell you what the immunity level is. And to give it at the time of neutering or better, as suture removal after neutering. Why would you bring in an animal to neuter or spay and give them a vaccine at the same time during that stress? You don't, but they come back in for suture removal or recheck in a week. Then you give the booster. That's so much more sense. And if you explain that to your clients, they get it already. Absolutely they get it. So you can even sell them a package deal. You know, we do all of these things after spay and neutering or whatever. This is what we recommend. Please remember to come back in and you send them a reminder for an update on what's going on. Those given 6 months core vaccine do not need one at 12 weeks of age. They don't need it. So again, that's an option depending on how you see this particular client. Okay, alternatively, you test the serum for bacillary immunity at 6 months of age. If the animal tests positive, you have an endogenous immune response and the animal's protected. Protection is assured based upon serum titer levels, no matter how high. It doesn't matter how high it is. It means you've got immune memory cells. However, if you have a relatively low titer that's protected, and you have a huge, massive exposure to virus or bacterium, the animal may not. It'll be less ill, but it may not have zero clinical signs. It just makes, again, common sense epidemiologically. Any measurable serum titer level means you have a committed immune memory immunity.